Jesus, beautiful. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus is beautiful, right?
Jesus beleza.
Okay. Now I use these two passages together. 1 Corinthians 6:17.
Aba Korinto bambere ibice bitandatu murongo wa 17.
1 Corinthians 6:17.
Ah, murongo wa 17 ngirito.
But whoever is united with the Lord is one with him in spirit.
Uifatanya n'Imana numwe numuka w'Imana.
So if we are united with Jesus, with the Lord, we are one with him in spirit. Our spirit has joined with the spirit of God. And his spirit has joined with us. And that is why Paul said, it's no longer me who lives, but it's Christ who lives in me. And
that
he lives in us, it's not just in some part of the body. But he lives with our spirit.
Is
one with our spirit.
That
his spirit and our spirit has joined together. That's why he can move in our hearts. He can move us to have, you know, to have heart to love God. He moves in us so that we can enjoy his love and joy and peace. And he moves in us so that we will serve God. Okay, now before I continue, I want to say something.
Now,
I should have said it the first day. Pay attention to how I preach. First, very often I would smile. And then I would use different facial expression. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. And I would show my feelings. And I make my relationship with God very real. And I'm also very free to move my body.
Start
from the feet. The whole person moves very freely. It's not just a hand moving. The whole person moving. And also you notice my voice. I will emphasize on certain words. When I say certain words, I will emphasize it. And I put feeling into my voice. Oh, Jesus, you're so wonderful. Hallelujah. Jesus is beautiful.
Oh, yes.
And I'm not afraid to smile or laugh in front of people. So I hope you're free like this when you preach.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Okay, now, the second passage we'll look at now. Philippians chapter 2, verse
13.
For it is God who works in you to will and to act in order to fulfill his good purpose. Now, I first explained these two passages before I will talk about God's nature. Okay, so God who works in us, he works in our heart to will and to act in order to fulfill his good purpose. It means that you will make up your mind, yes, I want to serve God. There is your will. I want to serve God. I want to praise God. I want to tell someone about Jesus. I want to visit him. I want to care about him. I want to pray. Do you have this desire? Sometimes you get up and say, yes, I want to pray, right? This passage just said it's God who works in you so that you want to pray. Have you noticed many times you don't want to forgive someone?
And then God moves
in our heart that we want to forgive.
No.
At first, we may not want to forgive someone.
We're
angry with someone. And God moves in our heart to forgive.
Sometimes we say,
I'm not willing. But God keep moving in our heart until we say, yes, Lord, I'm willing to forgive. So God, now very often we want to do something. And then God pulls you back, go a different direction. We don't want to forgive. And God pulls us to forgive. Some Christians want to commit adultery. And God pulls him back so that he will repent. So God works in our heart so that we will make up the mind to will. And then to act, to put in action. So God moves us to forgive, and then finally we forgive. Now very often we think, well, it's me who want to pray. But this passage tells us, when Christians want to do good, it is actually God moving in us that we want to do it. Now I want to say this, is we do it. We do forgive. It's we who forgive. God doesn't forgive for us. We do evangelism. God doesn't do the evangelism for us. But God moves in our heart that we want to do evangelism. And then we finally do it. Now this tells us about a very special union with God. In the first passage it says that we are one in spirit with God. But this passage also says that he moves in us so that we will make up our mind to do something and then to put it in action. But I want to say we don't become robots. You know, robots? That God say, okay, go forward. Go forward. It's not like this. It's God moves in our heart so that our heart is changed. So that we really want to save the people. We really want to serve God. That he changed us. I use an illustration. Now when a cow has drunk enough water, A cow has drunk enough water. Now we have a saying in Chinese. If the cow has enough water and doesn't want to drink, you cannot make it drink. So you push the head, go down and drink. But if it doesn't want to drink, you cannot make it go to drink. But if it wants to drink, you cannot stop it. So for us too, when we do not want to do evangelism, we don't have the heart to do it. But God changed our hearts so that we want to do it. Let me ask you, has it happened to you? In the past, you don't want to do evangelism, and now you want to do. In the past, we might not want to pray or worship, but now we like to worship and pray. So our heart has been changed. So the Bible tells us God can work in the heart into our soul to change our soul from a hard heart to a soft heart. The more we are in Him, the more we will change. Okay, now this is one part of us. There is another part of us. Romans chapter 7, beginning of verse 14. It talks about the sin that lives in us. The good I want to do, I don't do, but the sin I don't want to do, I do. So here it talks about our sinful nature. You know, at the same time, Christians, they, you know, have the heart to serve God. At the same time, we can be affected by our sinful nature. And even sometimes affected by Satan. When Jesus asked his disciples, "Who do you say I am?" And then Peter said, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." And Jesus said, "This is not blood, a flesh and blood that show you this." But it's my Father who is in heaven that shows, that revealed that to you. So Peter received that from God the Father. But then later said, Jesus said, "I want to go to Jerusalem to be crucified." And Peter said, no, you cannot go. And what did Jesus say? "Satan, get behind me." So Peter was used by Satan. So inside us we have the voice of God and also our sinful nature and also sometimes Satan's voice. Now, if my right hand represents the voice of God, and the left hand represents the sinful nature and Satan, let me ask you, are most Christians like this, that, you know, the good new nature from God is very strong and the sinful nature very weak?
Kamere y'Imana usanga ikomeye iri hejuru cyane y'icyaha ugasanga iri hasi.
Are most Christians like this?
Ese abakristo benshi abatijwe benshi ni ukubameze.
That they really love God?
Bakunda Imana cyane
by'ukuri. And obey God?
Bumvira Imana.
Care about people?
Bitaye ku bandi bantu.
Bring people to Jesus?
Bazi Yesu.
Treat our family members very well?
Bafata bagenzi babo mu muryango neza.
No fights in the family?
Bataje barwana meze nk'abamarayika iwabo.
Is it like that?
Nuko bimeze. Koma.
Or is it like a lot of times that anger comes out?
Twatizwe umutemera.
Frustration come out.
Ariko hari igihe uruno ibibazo bizamuka.
Selfishness come out.
Ubwibone n'ubwirasi no kwikunda bikagenda.
And your nature is very weak.
Noneho kamere y'Imana ugasanga imiterere y'Imana muri wowe yamanutse.
Let me ask you, most Christians, is it like this or like this?
Noneho nimumbwire. Abakristo benshi barazamutse bari hejuru bakora ibyiza ndavuga bakijijwe cyangwa ni bo kamere yabo kamere y'icyaha niyo iri hejuru.
So number one or number two?
Number one.
Number two. Actually, many Christians are number two that a sinful nature is strong. So what I say is, God works in us to will and to act according to the purpose of God. You know, He works like that, but the degree is different for each person.
Pero imana ukwikorera mu mitima yacu ituha ubushake iduha gukunda gukwikorera iduha umwete wo gushyira mu bikorwa ariko ikikeneye ukwikoresha umuntu.
The more we love God, the more the Holy Spirit moves in the heart.
Uko turushaho gukunda Imana, niko Umwuka Wera arushaho kugwiza imirimo muri twe.
And the more we become like Jesus.
Uko turushaho gusa na Yesu.
That we have His nature.
Niko turushaho kugira kamere ya Kristo.
So this verse talks about the work of God. All Christians must have the work of God.
Rero ibyanditse biratubwira ko buri muntu wakijijwe agomba kugira umurimo w'Imana agomba kugira n'imigendere nk'iy'Imana.
But it depends on how much.
Ariko bishingiye n'ukuntu usabana n'Imana.
Okay, now I want to go into the God's nature here.
Ngiye kuvuga kuri kamere y'Imana.
That is God who, you know, who work in us to will and to act according to fulfill the good purpose of God.
Uko Imana ikorera muri twe ituma ubushake tuba gushyira mu bikorwa kugira ngo dushobore gusohoza umugambi n'intego byayo.
First, God is a God of unity.
Icya mbere ni Imana y'ubumwe.
His unity with your soul is so strong you cannot separate it.
Ubumwe bw'Imana nta muntu n'umwe washobora kubutandukanya kuko burakomeye.
That He is working in our heart that sometimes you think is you, but when you obey God, it's actually God moving in us.
So
He unites Himself with us. Second, He doesn't despise us. Even when we are weak,
niyo turi abanyabyaha,
He continues to be united with us.
Ahubwo irakomeza ikadukurikirana.
He doesn't despise us.
Ntabwo idusuzugura.
And number three.
Icya gatatu.
When He unites with us, He works.
Kandi iyo yiyunze natwe, ikora imirimo yayo muri twe.
Wherever God is,
aho Imana iri hose,
He does good things.
Ikora ibyiza.
And when He does good things,
kandi ikoze byiza,
there is a purpose.
Hari intego.
Because He knows the future.
Kubera ko izi ejo hazaza.
He knows what is best.
Izi ibitubereye byiza.
So it says here to fulfill God's good purpose.
Rero ibikora kugira ngo isohoze umugambi, ibikorera kugira ngo dusohoze umugambi wayo.
So He has a purpose plan for us.
Rero idufitiye umugambi mwiza.
So if you have a close relationship with God,
rero iyo ufitanye ubumwe bukomeye n'Imana,
you follow the good purpose. ugakurikira imikambi yayo myiza, your life will go higher and higher. Ubuzima bwawe burushaho kuzamuka ikirenga. Nothing can stop you. Nta kintu cyagutandukanya n'Imana. And you can do greater, greater things. Kandi ushobora gukora imirimo ikomeye cyane. And it also gives us comfort.
Nanone ikatuhumuriza.
God is living in me.
Imana ibiri muri je.
God is working in me.
Imana irakora muri je.
If we really love God all the time.
Niba dukunda Imana rero cyane.
Now look at me.
Munde.
God is working here.
Imana iri gukoreramo.
Thank God.
Oh. Urashimira Imana.
You're working in my heart.
Urakorera mu mutima wanje.
You're giving me strength.
Urampa imbaraga.
You're giving me direction.
Urampa icyerekezo.
You're guiding me.
Uranyoboye.
You help me.
Uramfasha.
You use my life.
Urakoresha ubugingo bwanjye.
My life will go higher and higher.
Ubuzima bwanjye bukarushaho kuzamuka hejuru cyane.
So, first it works in our heart.
Icyambere ikorera mu mitima yacu.
He rejuvenates. He renew our heart.
Rero ibikora ihindura imitima yacu mishya, ihindura mishya.
Change it into a new heart.
Iduhindura kugira ngo tugire umutima mushya.
That we want to do something.
Rero ishaka kugira icyo ukora.
And give us a motivation to do it.
Ikaduha n'ishyaka ryo gukora.
Give us the strength to do it.
Ikaduha imbaraga zo gukora.
And a direction to do it.
Ikaduha n'icyerekezo cyo gukora.
You know, this message, I tell you, this message right here.
Ubutumwa mbabwiru.
Came to me the night before. When I was writing this document, I became very joyful. I said to God, I want to follow you all the time. And this verse tell me, I'm never alone. God is always working in me. And it's God working, moving me for that toward the direction. God is changing me. God is giving me power. God is giving me direction. So I know it's the right direction. And I can tell myself, thank God I'm following you. My life will be more and more blessed. And I start to pay attention to the voice inside me. When you want to pray, you say, thank God. I want to pray because God moves in my heart. You know, when I was praying like this, I was filled with the Holy Spirit very powerfully. So I hope that you all always believe. God's unity with us is so strong. You cannot shake it away. And He's doing good things in your heart. And God likes it. But if you follow your sinful nature, then you're destroying the voice of God. But if you're following God's voice, you'll hear more and more voice from God. You'll be guided by God more and more. You enjoy, will enjoy life more. Now,
it's time.
I hope you will think about this. This message is very, very important. Let me look at me.
Oh, no, Mundele.
This is how I live. God is in me now. God is moving in my heart.
Now.
God is moving me to pray to God. God is giving me joy. God is using me to bless more people. God is giving me new teachings. God is using my life. God is raising my life up. God is guiding me all the way.
To
go deeper and deeper. I hope when you hear this, it really go into your heart. Do you like this? This very, very strong union with God?
Hallelujah.
God is so wonderful.
Imana irahambaye.
He's not just far away.
Ntabiri kure.
He unites with us in such a way.
Yo yiyunze natwe muri ubwo buryo.
That all our thoughts and actions could come from him.
Icyo gihe imbaraga no gukomera biva ku Mana.
Now I just want to conclude with this kind of message. What outline can you have?
Pero,
what outline? You know, sermon outline, message outline.
Pero ntangira ngo soze mvuga uko ubutumwa ufite bumeze umurongo.
Now with this message here, now with this message, first I will talk about the negative examples of people.
Rero hano iyo mvuze kuri ubu butumwa mvuga ku bantu bafite imitekerereze mibi.
People don't have, they don't appreciate this strong union with God.
Abantu batishimira ubusabane bukomeye bagirana n'Imana.
They don't realize that God is so tightly, you know, united with them.
Batazi neza ko Imana ifitanye nabo ubumwe.
So they don't have strength.
And they
think God is far away.
Bibwira ko Imana iri kure cyane.
And then God's nature.
Neno kamere y'Imana.
God's nature, he wants unity.
Neno kamere y'Imana, Imana ishaka ubumwe.
He's united with us.
Iba yiyunze natwe.
He works in us.
Ikorera muri twe.
To give us the desire.
Ikaduha icyifuzo.
Give us motivation.
Ikaduha gushishikariza. Ikadushishikariza.
Give us power to follow him.
Ikaduha imbaraga zo kwikurikira.
Give us the direction.
Iduha icyerekezo.
So that is the nature of God. The second point. First point is.
Yo mikamere y'Imana cyangwa imiterere y'Imana.
First point is people's problem. People's problem.
Icya mbere ni ibibazo by'abantu.
Second point is God's nature.
Ariko icya kabiri uko Imana iteye.
Third point.
Icya gatatu.
Why don't people have this nature of God? Why don't they?
Kuki abantu badafite uwa mutima w'Imana ya kamere y'Imana?
They don't take it because they're lazy.
Imana batagira kamere y'Imana cyangwa imiterere y'Imana gukora abanebwe.
They don't take it because they think they follow the world to get more.
Ntibakurikira kamere y'Imana kubera ko bashaka gukurikira isi kuko batekerezamo byinshi byiza.
They don't take it because they don't believe God has so many good things.
Imana batagira kamere y'Imana nuko batizera ko Imana ibafitiye byinshi, ko Imana itunze byose, ko Imana ishobora byose.
And number four is how.
Nanone ingingo ya kane ni gute.
This is the law.
Iri ni itegeko.
So we have the grace, God's nature.
Dufite ubuntu bw'Imana.
And here's the law.
Kandi ku itegeko.
If God has this unity with us.
Niba Imana ifitanye ubumwe natwe.
Do you want to appreciate that?
Murashaka kwishimira ibyo?
And live in that union with God.
Je nibera muri ubwo bumwe bwanjye n'Imana.
And let God guide us all the time.
Nimerera Imana ngo inyobore ibihe byose.
And then we can hear from God all the time.
Noneho tukumva ijwi ry'Imana ibihe byose.
And we have power to follow him.
Noneho tukagira imbaraga zo kwikurikira.
And we can become greater and greater.
Noneho tukarushaho gukomera no gukomera.
When we trust in him.
Iyo twiringiye Imana.
And pray much to him.
None to the same that cyane imbere yayo. Tumvira Imana.
Serve him.
Dukorera iyo Mana.
Put away all the worldly thoughts.
None nitekereze yisi na kamera zisi tukabyigizayo.
Put away all the frustration.
Tukazibukira ibindi byose byisi.
And concentrate in God alone.
Ibindi byose tukabifasha hasi tugatekereza ku Mana yonyine.
Then we'll go higher and higher.
Tuzarushaho kuzamuka ikirenga.
Let me tell you the two nights, last night and the night before, I worked on this message and another message came and I was so filled with joy in my room. I really enjoy that.
Amajoro abiri maze kandi murabibona ko maze iminsi nigisha neza. Amajoro abiri rwose nkurikije naraye amajoro ntegurize inyigisho. Ariko nasekaga nimo ntegura nkishima cyane nkasa n'umuntu urimo gukirigita.
So the more we enter God, we more enjoy God.
Uko narushijeho gucengera mu ijambo ariko narushijeho kwishima cyane.
The more we enter God, the more strength we have.
Uko narushijeho gucengera mu Mana ariko narushijeho kugira imbaraga n'ibyishimo.
The more we enter God, the higher we'll go.
Uko turushaho kwinjira mu Mana niko turushaho kuzamuka mu rwego rw'ikirenga.
Okay, and then the fifth point, challenge.
Noneho ingingo ya gatanu ni ibihinyuza.
Let me ask you, do you think you're wiser or is God wiser?
Noneho reka nkubaze ikibazo. Niwe munyabwenge kuruta Imana cyangwa Imana niyo nyabwenge kukuruta?
Who is wiser?
Umunyabwenge kuruta niwe.
But many people follow their own wisdom.
Ariko abantu benshi bibwira ko aribo banyabwenge bakurikira ubwenge bwabo.
Actually is foolishness.
Ariko reka mbabwire ko ubwenge bw'abantu n'ubupfapfa n'ubupfu.
They think they're smarter than God.
Abantu bakibwira ko ari abahanga cyane kurusha Imana.
But we follow God, we have the best, the highest wisdom.
Ariko iyo dukurikiye Imana tugira ubwenge busumba ubwenge bwose.
Okay, now do you see this method of preaching and Bible study?
Iyi myigishirize yanjye murabona irimo kuza.
Now, can I take 2 minutes to describe for the first message the few points?
Okay, 2 minutes. In a
okay. So the what happened to the woman with the 12-year bleeding? That God knows our heart and cares about our heart and comforts our heart. And He wants a deep relationship. The first point is, many people don't realize God is so caring. That's why many people suffer. Many Christians don't have strength. And then second point, God's nature. He's a caring God. And He can care. And He can also, He wants a deep relationship. And with faith we can receive healing and inner healing, physical healing and inner healing. And then point number 3. Why don't many people have this comfort of God? Because many people don't know God can comfort us like that. Because many people don't believe that God cares so much about us. And God is so caring. And then number 4, how can we receive this blessing? Just by faith. Like this woman. Hold on to God. So there is always a how.
Hari uko.
This is the law.
Nitegeko.
What should we do?
Kwabigenza dute.
To let Jesus' comfort come to us.
Kugira ngo uhumurizwa na Yesu bitugereho.
And to live in this relationship with God.
No kuba tubugize ubusabane bwiza na Yesu.
And then fifth point, to challenge the people.
Ingingo ya gatatu, guhinyuza abantu.
Do you want to be the son and daughter and enjoying God all the time? And be comforted by God all the time? Or do you want to live in a lonely way? Okay, so now let me tell you, this preaching method is not easy to learn. You have to spend more time studying the Bible and think about God's nature. And how to apply it to our life. Now, if you have a cell phone and can get online, you can give me your cell phone number and then I can send you the documents to you.
Rwose nziza ushobora kujya ku murongo kuri internet n'ibindi wambi nomero zawe kujya ngo ujye umwoherereza inyigisho.
When I have these documents I can send to you to help you.
Kugira ngo ujye umwoherereza ariko ugomba kuba uzi Igishinwa nk'icyo mvuga.
Okay. Now, earlier I talked about how to handle negative thinking and feeling.
Rero mwabyumvise ukuntu ushobora gukemura imitekerereze mibi cyangwa ibyiyumviro bibi ukuntu ushobora kwivana muri icyo kibazo.
Always be positive.
Igihe cyose witeguye kuzavuga ibintu byiza utekereza byiza urabyiteguye n'umugiteguye manika baboko.
I want to say that if you want to live like that, it has to be intentional.
Rero niba ushaka kubaho bene muri ubwo buzima ugomba kubigambirira.
All the time you say I want to live in the joy of the Lord.
Ukavanga ibihe byose ndashaka kwibera mu munezero w'Imana.
I want to be changed by God.
Ndashaka guhindurwa n'Imana.
I want to live out his full plan.
Ndashaka kubaho mu mugambi w'Imana, mu mwuzuro w'umugambi w'Imana.
I don't want to be affected by people.
Ntabwo nshaka ko iby'abantu bamvuga bizangiraho ingaruka.
Okay, it has to be intentional.
Ugomba kubigambirira.
Okay, God bless you all.
Imana ibahe umugisha mwese.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.